Mama Eileen Ogola and your family, our religious leaders, colleagues, leaders present, this is here and the military fraternity, ladies and gentlemen. On Thursday, April 18, 2024, General Francis Ogola, the Chief of the Defense Forces, along with 11 others, including the crew, departed Nairobi County to visit troops operating under Operation Maliza Uadilifu and to inspect ongoing rehabilitation of schools program in the north. By midday, the CDF and his entourage had traversed Baringo County, Turkana County, Elgeyo Marakwet County, destined for Uasin Gishu County, where he was to visit the recruit training school, where I had agreed with him on certain benefits that needed to be adjusted. Unfortunately, this was not to be, as the helicopter crashed at Sindar Area Cabin Location, third division in Elgeyo Marakwet County, claiming the lives of General Ogola, Brigadier Swale Saidi, Colonel Duncan Keitan, Lieutenant Colonel David Sala, Major George Benson Magondu, Captain Sora Mohamed, Captain Hilary Vitali, Senior Sergeant John Kinwa Murray, Sergeant Clifford Omoni, and Sergeant Rose Nyawe. Indeed, it was a sad and tragic moment for us as a nation and for the KDF fraternity. In hospital as we speak, our Lieutenant Colonel Kasaine Ole Koruta and Corporal Franco Karanji, who I ask all of us to pray for them, for their recovery. They are in fair condition and we wish them well. Over the course of my life in the public service, I have had the privilege to meet, interact and work with many outstanding men and women whose achievements and visions represent the best of what Kenya has to offer. General Ogola was in a very special place. Yesterday, as I thought of this tragedy and what I was going to say, the truth came to my mind to speak truthfully about the man that lies in the casket in front of us. Because General Ogola represents the best of what Kenya has to offer. We are meeting here for this fair service, for the first ever in the history of Kenya, of Basari, Chief of Defense Forces, in office, who has passed on. And we are here to say bye-bye to a consummate military officer, a passionate, a accomplished military commander and a patriotic citizen of Kenya with great humility. Lessons on humility, characterize the life of General Obonna. Even in his death, he is giving us lessons and lectures on humility. This very function is the epitome of humility. And when it came time for me as Commander-in-Chief to make a decision on the next CDA, it wasn't an easy decision as it should. It's always a decision of many balances. But anyway, let me say this about General Obonna. All the recommendations that I got on the next CDA and all the advice that I got about the next CDA did not include the name of General Obonna, unfortunately. But he was a military officer who had a distinct charm. There was only one problem. The events of the 15th of August at the Bomas of Kenya. And so, General Obonna for a meeting. And I had a one-on-one, man-to-man, come to Jesus meeting with General Obonna. And when we concluded that meeting, General Obonna told me the following: Mr. President, I have no defense. I will not try to defend myself. It was wrong, no matter. And you have three choices. Either send me to court-martial, or have me retire, or forgive me. Where someone sends us on the side, and I was there.